220, and that's basically how much I want to weigh. Yeah, I've tried putting on as much weight as I can, and I've gotten up to 230 a couple times, maybe 235, but because the weightlifting guys say that we should weigh 245. Right. And as a man, but the extra weight doesn't seem to really help you after 200 pounds or 210. Bang energy drink. And I'm using three cameras in this video: my iPhone, my MacBook, and my Chromebook. And this video is just the workout with those three cameras edited together, repeating, just so I can see how the different cameras film. And it was a long and arduous process trying to get all that footage together on one computer and edit it, because it was the first time I was really using the video function on my iPhone. And I'm getting better at it. I'm going to be using it all the time, I think. I got the selfie stick and everything, because I'm using a selfie stick to hold the iPhone. Yeah, I've been working on this all day, but was filmed 2 weeks ago. And I'm really proud of it, and I think everything about this is just tight. Just having a great time working out. And I also have a lot of remorse about working out, which I'll probably cover in future videos, talking about all of the problems with it. And how, I'm not proud of the weights I'm lifting right now, but I guess I am trying to show off as a heavyweight individual or overweight. Because when I was in high school, when I weighed 150, deadlifting 135 is actually like how much you can deadlift. It's also how much you can bench, basically. And you feel good about doing it. But then there's actually nothing impressive about deadlifting 135 or benching it. But it's still kind of impressive shoulder pressing it. And then, here's another kicker, is you're just supposed to count in plates, basically, and how many plates you can put on, 45-pound plates. And they basically tell you to not even mess around with the little stuff, but I do it anyways because it came with the weight set. And anyone that actually works out and is good at this stuff isn't going to be impressed with any of my videos, and I'm just going to be looking kind of creepy and deranged, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, it feels pretty weird exposing myself to the camera, because it's a lot of my body going off now. But I already bought all this weight equipment, and something I keep on doing on and off over my life. So, I'm trying to share one of my hobbies: exercise, weightlifting. Yeah, it's just one of those things. And then yeah, that's showing off sumo deadlift and normal deadlift. And sumo is just with wider stance. And online it said that can be better for heavier people, but I don't notice a difference. Yeah. And then there's also some arguments or debates about the grip, because one hand should be going the other direction, and I don't do that because of power cleans and hang cleans that, you know, I'm used to flipping the thing up a little bit and catching it, but only a little bit because I don't really like that exercise. And, you know, but yeah, then sometimes I'll just, you know, have my hand going the other way because that's what they tell you to do, sort of. And, yeah. I mean, it's not really that interesting or fascinating. I don't know if I'm gonna have to refilm the whole video and put my face on the other side of the screen. I hope not. I hope this is going well. Kind of sucks to spend all that time stitching all these different clips together and then have bad video commentary for my face to be covering up something important on the screen. Now just more me going off. There's sped up a little bit, and then yeah, all that little fumbling around with the weight. And it's just like, are you just doing one rep each time? Like, aren't you supposed to do more? And it's just like, yeah, you're supposed to do more in weight training. We would do like 4 sets of 4. But when I was showing this to my friend at the gym, he would do 10. Because he just thinks you're supposed to do 10 of any exercise. That's just what you do. You do 10. And it's just like, well, you know, deadlift is a little bit different. And he's like, what's different about deadlift? And it's just like, yeah, it's just you can hurt your back doing this, you know. And that's why I'm taking it so easy. And you only need to do it a little bit, a few times. And then in like a month or two, you're going to have dramatic improvements, and then it's just going to flatline there. It's pretty interesting, actually, because you start putting on so much more weight. I mean, it's not that interesting. Yeah, it's pretty cool. You know, it's the most you can lift without using a machine that you're just like, lifting with the machine, you know, because I don't know how that's cool. Maybe it's slightly cool. Yeah. I think this is 10 minutes, actually, now that I'm looking at it. It's like 10 minutes of me deadlifting. And yeah, just going through all the exercises, just doing one rep, basically. Working out for an hour, you know, it's just like you can't really feel good about it if you keep going, because it's not reasonable to work out more than an hour every day or every other day. So you're putting too much time into it. Or yeah, you can do whatever you want, you know, it's your life. And like so many other things you can see people doing at the gym, it's like, is that all you're going to do? Yeah, I came here just to do this one thing. And tinker with the weight a little bit. Yeah, put those little half pounds on. Yeah, here we go. And how silly that looks. But, you know, yeah, that's fine. It's fine. You know, like I say, you almost don't even want to do this lift at all. or don't even touch a barbell because I feel like it gives you weightlifter's mentality where you just want to lift more weight on the barbell. And yeah, that's fine if you do. It's whatever you decide for yourself what you want your fitness goal and plan to be. But I have no problem with someone just not even touching the thing. And don't even touch the barbell. And you know, when I'm doing this, I'm thinking, oh my god, I'm going to be doing these deadlifts every day or every other day for the next 7 to 20 years trying to maintain the fitness I'm getting from it. I'm going to be grabbing that barbell so much. It's like the thing owns you now. Same with that treadmill. And what happens when the treadmill is going to eventually wear down and break faster than the barbell because it's got more moving parts? Man, you need to have that barbell strength in order to move that, because I'm actually upstairs right now, and you're going to need that barbell strength in order to move a treadmill up and down stairs. Yeah. You know, or I guess it would help if you had a couple of friends, but one of them's probably going to mess up. It's, you know, a dangerous thing you're asking them for help for. You know, it's like, that's a heavy object. Yeah, closing in on 10 minutes of watching myself deadlift, and yeah, I feel pretty weird showing this off to people. Yeah, and then you know, this is like the early stage of the exercising. Hopefully I get in better shape, but then it's also weird just bragging about being in good shape. Yeah. Well, you know, just let it happen. And it is kind of like impressive and cool and prestigious the first time you try it out. It's like, yeah, you know, you're a cool guy just for doing that thing. But then also, like, no, and just stay away from it. Maybe, you know, I'm being overly mindful about this. I just feel ridiculous having this set up, but actually a lot of people have strength cages around here. I mean, yeah, I'll walk around, I'll see all these people with barbells and strength cages, and it's like, yeah, that's the way to go. But at the same time, it's like, right, yeah, we all need this thing. Oh, no. And now I'm showing you my before and afters. I don't know if I did this last time. I'm showing you the condition of my body right now. It's like, well, that's not fair. You already worked out a little bit. You've got a pump going. Yeah, showing you my fat body so I can then, you know, expose myself to you again in several months and see if, you think sad thoughts. Think sad and depressing thoughts. You're an ape. You're a gorilla. Yeah, now you're the Hunchback of Notre Dame, Quasimodo. Yeah, stand up a little bit. Yeah, there we go. And I just like the difference between flexing and stuff, but you can't just walk around flexing all the time. And then, you know, when you take pictures of yourself flexing, you create a artificial reality or something, a projection of yourself that you don't live up to. But everyone does it. Yeah, well, you can go ahead and turn the video off if it's making you uncomfortable. I won't be offended. It's actually sort of gross, a guy doing this to you, but hey, we're men, we're weightlifters. Sort of. Yeah, I'm not really too sure if it is, like, weird or if it's okay. A lot of that stuff is gonna be like that. You know, where when something does look weird, I don't know if it is. You know, maybe it is weird. So yeah, maybe we shouldn't do that one. Yeah, pull-up time. You know, and I always had a pull-up bar in my doorway, and I could never use it because of the dog. You open up your door, and the dog comes running and wants to play, or you're afraid that's what's gonna happen. So you never use the thing. And even then, how good are pull-ups really? Because if you weigh 150, you can probably do 10 of them. And if you weigh 200 or more, maybe you can do one. And that's, you know, like your starting shape. You have to get in better shape from there. It's like, how many years have you been working out for consistently without any breaks? Oh no, I had a break. I have to start over again. Yeah, I mean, you know, this barbell is better than a barbell. I mean, the pull-up bar is better than one that that's in the doorway, because you don't need to open your door to use it. But another thing about the doorway pull-up bar is that it damages the door frame. And that's probably like $75 worth of damage. And you think $75, you know, maybe that's a lot to you, maybe it's not. But the strength cage itself is only like $100. So yeah, I don't know, maybe you shouldn't be putting holes in your wall and, you know, cracks on your door frame, you know. Or maybe some of that stuff is gonna happen, you know, it depends on the person and what you're getting yourself into. But here's the thing about this pull-up bar, is I almost always have my barbell on the strength cage, so it's another thing getting in the way. But at the same time, it doesn't really matter, because I firmly believe that you need to exercise before you shower, and you can't just randomly keep on exercising throughout the day, because every time you start exercising, you're gonna start sweating. So it's just like, yeah, you gotta focus all your exercise into one part of the day before you shower, unless you're gonna shower more than once a day. It's all stuff for you to figure out. Or you might even try and go through a period, well, let's see what happens if I don't shower, and what it's like if I'm just gonna stink. Yeah. Just gonna stink all the time and have BO, and, you know, develop a fungus or something because I'm not wiping the sweat off. We'll get, you know, athlete's foot or ringworm or something. It's like, yeah, I thought I could just, you know, tough it out. Now, I don't know how likely that's going to happen. Now, yeah, and I can't wait to do more of these videos, too. And the next video is going to just be a bunch of times that I got on the treadmill. Yeah, not a lot of progress was happening during these first 2 weeks to a month, but I know all my stuff is going to jump up and into the next fitness level just from, you know, keeping at it a little bit. And what really slows me down is doing these videos, and that's because I'm trying to go to the next level of video editing, and then even then, they're still not very good. And yeah, well, you know, I'm just messing around on here, you know? This is time we're spending together a little bit, indefinitely. Yeah, and I'm gonna shave the beard soon and get a haircut. I am. It's only happening because of COVID. I just haven't, you know, I've been wearing those masks and that let my shaving go. And then the clippers broke. I have new clippers already. I just haven't gotten them out of the box. I just haven't been going to the haircut place in 2 years because of COVID. That's just my excuse, though. But it's also like, I don't think my hair or beard will ever be this long again. As it was not my intention to grow it out in the first place. But it's kind of a novel thing, you know? So far, no one's really made any comments. No, I am kind of self-aware. Yeah, and I'm better at deadlifts than I am at squats. Yeah, you just need to keep on doing them for a while, and then you'll get better at them. And going down all the way, and then, you know, when you videotape yourself, it does not feel good because squats are very, very revealing. You can really see your stomach ooze over your midsection. Look at that. Yeah, hopefully that gets better over time. Yeah, I can't, if you had secrets to hide, you know, this really exposed what your body is really like. In a way. Yeah, those squats were just sort of garbage. I'll get better at them, though. It's almost even hard to defend a lot of this behavior stuff. But we'll see how it goes this time. Yeah, you just have to really like doing this stuff. And then you have to also develop the mindset that you won't let what anyone else says to you. You won't let that affect you. Yeah. Gotta be determined. And we'll go over more conversation stuff in future videos. This is all just practice for me. I'm just getting warmed up. And I'm also, you know, just getting used to using a new laptop. And also the selfie stick with the iPhone. It's like, hey, maybe get a real camera too sometime. Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, and it's gonna be like the next time I make a video, I'm gonna be able to deadlift 300 pounds and, you know, bench like 235 or something. And then, you know, 235 to 250. It's gonna happen quick because I've already done it before and it's, you know, not that impressive. And it's gonna be this like huge improvement over the first couple weeks or 2 months. But any improvement that you're gonna make is gonna be like done in 6 months and you're not gonna be able to improve at all. You're gonna have to just keep on doing it. And then, you know, you'll make really small improvements over the next year, and that's where why you need to get into HIIT, high intensity interval training. I'm gonna be working on that too. And you know, starting up with some Tai Chi and yoga, I almost feel like doing some of that more than the last couple years. Just sort of fun. Yeah, well, it'll be interesting to see if I can ever get that stomach off. And oh, here, check this out. Yeah, I made a whole bunch of loops of just me doing the rep that I can just leave playing. And that also messes with my mind a bit. Like, what the? Is this what I'm trying to do? This is insane. And then also, yeah, just all those windows open. It's nuts. This is with the Photos app. With Photos, you can open as many windows, well, not as many as you want, but you can open a bunch of windows, even of the same video. I don't know if that's doing anything for you. It's doing something for me. And then you can do the same thing on QuickTime. Yeah. So yeah, that's great. And yeah, just leave a whole bunch of looped videos going on Photos and QuickTime playing. Same with iTunes, make a little short 6 second audio file and leave that playing on loop overnight. Just so you can have really outrageous scores on those things. Just like a video game. And a program that you respect. $220.